In this session, we're going to talk about working with tabby responsive tabs, which allow you to add tabs to a page. You can have several subpages within a page. I'm at the Tri River area WordPress site, so let me quickly show you what this looks like in action. I'll go to their topic areas menu and go to Family and Consumer Science, and we can see that they have five tabs here: Overview, Publications, Hot Topics, Programs, and Resources. And each of these tabs has its own separate content. So in this session, we'll learn how to build tabs on a page. We're now here on my site, the Tech Training WordPress site. So let's learn how to build tabs into a page. We'll start by going into the dashboard. Now, Tabby Responsive Tabs is a plugin that is already activated on your site when it comes from us, when it comes from the tech unit here at CSU Extension. So all you need to do to implement it is use tiny little pieces of code, which are called short codes. Let's say we want to build a new page called Working with WordPress, and inside that page we want four tabs, each with their own content. The four tabs we'll build will be Dashboard, Adding Content, Widgets, and Plugins. So let's begin. We'll first hover over Pages and then choose the Add New option. And this dialog box shows up. I'll put my title here in the Enter Title Here box. And here is our title, Working with WordPress. We now move to the body of our page, just below it, and we'll create our first tab. We'll start with a bracket. We'll add the word tabby. We'll add a space. We'll add the word title, an equal sign, our first quotation, and here's where the title of the tab goes. You can use spaces here. I'll put dashboard. I'll finish my quotation marks, and I'll finish my tab. I'll hit enter, so I have a space below it, and that is our first tab. We'll then add some generic content for our dashboard section of our page. And here is our content. We have a heading 2 header, which I can tell by clicking on the heading and looking up here in the formatting box. It says heading 2. And then this chunk is a paragraph. Again, I can find that out by clicking within my text and looking at my format drop-down box. With our content in here, we'll hit enter, and we'll create our second tab. We'll start with a bracket. We'll start with tabby, a space, the word title, equal sign, our quote mark. This will be adding content. We'll finish our quotation mark, and we'll finish our bracket. And now we're ready to add the content to our second tab. Here is the dummy content for our second tab. Our third tab will be widgets. Here's the short code for our widgets tab: bracket, tabby, space, title, equal sign, quotation mark, our tab title, widgets, the second quotation mark, and then the closing bracket. We then have our heading, and we then have our body text. And here is the short code for our plugin section: tabby, title, plugins, our heading, and our body text. And now we're done with our four tabs: dashboard, adding content, widgets, and plugins. We'll now finish it off with our final short code, which is tabby ending in brackets. So bracket, the word tabby ending with no space, and then closing bracket, and we're done. So we'll go to the upper right hand corner, we'll click Save Draft. We'll then click Preview, and here are our four tabs: Dashboard, Adding Content, Widgets, and Plugins. Now, by default, this is going to open up on your first tab to the left. If you want another tab to open up when this page is first open, that's easy to fix with another parameter within the short code. Let's say we want Adding Content, our second tab, to open by default when this page is opened. We'll go back to our dashboard. We'll go back to Pages and All Pages. And right now we have this as a draft page, so we'll click Edit. We're going to go to the short code for adding content right here. I move my cursor to just after that last quotation mark, space, the word open, equal sign, first quotation mark, Yes, second quotation mark, and we already have that closing bracket. So we'll click Save Draft. And we'll now click Preview. It's the same exact page, except now Adding Content is the tab that opens up by default. One last little trick, and we'll call it a day. Let's say we want to link not only to this page, but to a specific tab within this page. Let's say the Widgets tab. Well, this is our permalink, so this is the URL we would use to link to the actual page. So let's start with that. I'm going to copy and paste this. So I'll right-click and choose Copy. We'll go to the page we want to link to that tab. Here we are on my archived webinars page and the most recent webinar, Theme Options in WordPress. And I've got text here that says more about widgets. So I'm going to select this text. I'm going to my Insert Edit Link button. I will click that. More about widgets is my link tab. I will paste in the URL. A little trick with WordPress is that when you're adding a URL with a cut and paste from a permalink, it usually adds a space there at the end, which will mean that your link won't work. So after you cut and paste in your link, do a backspace to get rid of that last space. With that done, let's now add the section of our URL that will link it to the proper tab. I'll move my cursor to just after the forward slash. I'll put in a question mark. I'll put in the word target and an equal sign. Now we're going to use the name of the tab, but we're not going to use capitalized letters, and we're not going to use spaces, and we're not going to use quotation marks. We simply type in the word widgets. We'll click Add Link. We will update our page. We'll then go to Preview Changes. And here's our link down here, More About Widgets. So we'll click that, and it takes us to the Widgets tab of our Working with WordPress page.